Deputy Healy.
Tánaiste, the policies of successive Irish governments have allowed an elite golden circle of the rich and powerful in this country to obtain obscene levels of wealth, while the vast majority have seen their incomes reduced and struggle day in, day out to make ends meet. Irish society is and is becoming more and more unequal. That is the message coming from the meeting in Davos last week and the Paris School of Economics. It is the message coming from Oxfam. It's the message coming from our own Central Statistics Office and from the Economic and Social Research Institute. It's also the message, Taoiseach, coming from Irish Water's huge payments to consultants, many of them the same companies, individuals who were paid for bad advice and bad oversight during the boom. It's a message coming from the payment of bonuses, the breach of pay limits for government advisers, and the payment of huge pensions, and the list goes on. The Paris School of Economics in this recent study showed that 1% of the wealthiest 1% of people in Ireland own 10% of national income and is the seventh worst in inequality terms of the 18 countries studied. Accumulated wealth is even more significant and stark. 5% of the 5% of wealthiest families in this country own 47% of the wealth. And since your government came to power, the wealthiest 300 individuals in this country have gained 9 billion euros or 30 million euros each. The Central Statistics Office have told us that during the course of the recession, the wealthiest 10% of people in this country have seen their incomes rise, while the other 90% have seen their incomes fall. And the fall has got bigger as incomes have got smaller.
Question, please.
The Economic and Social Research Institute have independently studied the last three budgets and found it to be regressive. And that means that the budgets have taken the most from those that have the least. Low and middle income
families.
Sorry,
Deputy, this is not speech time, this is question time. Would you put your question?
I'm putting the question now, Kian Corla. Low and middle income families have had their incomes undermined. They've been fleeced by increased taxes, unfair household tax.
Deputy, I won't ask you again. Would you put your question, please? Not statements.
How in those circumstances, Tánaiste, how in those circumstances can your government justify introducing a new regressive water tax on these families who are already at their wits' end?
Thank you. Tánaiste.
Well, I share with Deputy Healy a wish to see equity in our society and to see fair taxation and to see that those who are in the best position to make a contribution to the finances of the state do so. The problem is that every time that we propose any measures in that regard, Deputy Healy, you oppose them. This government, for example, introduced a number of measures in relation to the increasing of capital taxation, capital gains tax, capital acquisitions tax, dirt tax on deposits. To my recollection, Deputy Healy, you opposed all of those. When we introduced a property tax, my recollection is that you opposed that as well. I'm certainly open, Deputy Healy, to hearing from you specific proposals about either tax measures or measures that will contribute to greater equity. There's no point in coming into the Dáil, Deputy Healy, and getting up and bemoaning inequality and excessive wealth and all of that, and then opposing, 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 then opposing, then opposing every measure that is introduced to deal with it. We have now, if you look at the OECD examination of taxation system, you mentioned the top 1%, Deputy, top 1% of earners in this country now pay about 20% of the income tax. The top 5% that you mentioned as well, they now pay around 40% of all of the income tax that's paid in this country. The OECD consider the Irish tax system to be now one of the most progressive in the OECD system. But I'm open. I'm open to hearing any specific and worthwhile proposals that you have, Deputy Healy, to improve on that.
Thank you. Deputy Healy, 1 minute, thank you.
Well, we've just heard the usual spin and indeed untruths from the Taoiseach. I, of course, have proposed wealth and assets tax in this chamber on numerous occasions, and indeed in budget submissions. And of course, the top 1%, indeed the top 10% in this country, have a completely disproportionate share of national income. And your government has refused to implement a wealth or an assets tax. But I want to say this to you, Taoiseach. You're on record as opposing water charges. And if I could quote something you said, and I'm quoting,
Deputy, this the POA is not about taxpayer
has already paid enough
please.
For local services and should not have to pay again. In 1994, you said they have imposed a residential property tax.
This would is you the put your supplementary question,
government,
please? Thank you.
And are now making us pay for water as well. And in 97, you said when water charges were abolished, you said water charges were a form of double taxation and the government were right to abolish them.
Would you put
now,
your supplementary question?
In circumstances where you're on record on this, in circumstances where the vast majority of people in this country are fleeced and have been crucified over the last number of years, in those circumstances where you have
access
to wealth and assets tax of very rich people in this country, will you and your government now withdraw the water charges
proposed to
commence in November of this year?
Okay, well, let's take the issue of wealth taxes. There are three essential forms of wealth, Deputy Healy.
Sorry, would you mind, please? Listen to the reply, whether you like it or not.
There are three essential forms of wealth. There's property, pensions are a large part of wealth these days, and there's money. On all of those three areas of wealth, this government has introduced additional taxes. We've introduced property tax. We've introduced additional capital taxes. We've introduced an additional tax on pensions that yield over 60,000 a year, and we've also introduced additional taxes on money. Now, it's all very well. You see, this idea of coming in and saying, well, let's tax wealth. Now, that's a grand idea, and it sounds great and wonderful, until the government actually comes to do it. And then when the government comes to do it, in reality, Deputy Healy opposes it every particular time.
Sorry, Deputy, but Sorry, would you mind, please? We're over time. Now, if you don't want to hear the reply, I'll just cut off the debate. Thank you.
In relation to the issue of water, as you know, Deputy Healy, this government has decided that we are going to make sustainable provision for water services in this country for probably the next quarter century or more. That's a prudent thing to do, because the previous government didn't do that. We have made it clear in our programme for government that there will be a charging arrangement which will be based on a metered system, that there will be a free water allowance for households, and that charging for water will be on a metered basis beyond that free allowance.
Thank you.
And instead of exaggerating and telling people that that this cost is going to be very excessive, you can be sure that the government is very much on the side of families and households on this issue.
Thank you. That completes leaders' questions for today.